Oxygen tank so he can breathe. It's kind of like the guy from Blue Knight. breathing in his oxygen tank, and he lifts up the, you know, the thing on his turntable there, the needle, and he puts it down, and he starts off his beautiful afternoon with all this stuff, playing his one of his favorite old rock songs from the old days. There he is, sucking his eyes. After midnight, we gonna let the whole hang out. After midnight, we gonna chug the rain shot. We gonna stimulate some action. We gonna get some satisfaction. We gonna find out what it is all about. Things are starting to get a little weird. He's kind of feeling strange, so he sucks more on the oxygen tank. He tries to get some air because he can't really figure out what's going on. It's getting strange. Sucks a little more on the oxygen tank. Starts thinking to himself, I wonder if I should have bought that oxygen tank in the parking lot at the fish show. The guy told me it was an oxygen tank. Oh.
only hurt just a little bit.
Bell-like sounds in his mind, and then after a couple of minutes his head starts to clear a little bit, he starts to feel a little bit better, and the bells start going away, and as he sits there he looks down to his left and he thinks, oh my god, there's my cat, that'll help me come back to reality. And he starts petting his cat, his beautiful furry black cat, and he's petting his cat and looks down and he says, I love you, my little cat. Bye. Poster, not bad. At least you're still here with me. And he says, I love having a cat. I love cats. I love having a pet. I love having a pet cat. As a matter of fact, I wonder how long people have been keeping cats for pets.
Egyptians until today, many people have been cat fanciers. You are such a person. Your cat is a big, beautiful black animal. His appearance is much like a panther as a cat. Your pet is a very friendly one. Each day as you come home from work, he shows you his affection by purring and rubbing his sleek fur against your legs as you reach down to scratch his head. Until one day.
Thank you.
little pet cat. It all starts to kick in again. All of a sudden, he's getting dizzy. He's back in a dark dream state. He doesn't know how this happened. He's petting the cat. And suddenly, he's back in another dream state. And he hears this voice inside his dream head. And it sounds something like this. I'm walking down a corridor on a boat, swaying gently. I am hungry, but I have to go quickly. I walk briskly past a family of four, a young child and a tiny, tiny little cat. So soft and tiny. I keep walking, and there beside me is a tray of hors d'oeuvres, and I'm so hungry, so I grab one. I'm late for sound check, so I must keep walking. Pop the thing in my mouth, keep walking, and realize there's something between my teeth. Something furry. And I pull that out of my teeth, and then there's a little more, and then I realize that, unfortunately, I ate that cat. It was tiny, and it was a little poster nutbag. Look! The storm's gone. Jimmy? Yes, Dad? Jimmy, I have some bad news for you. What is it, Dad? It's about your cat. Little PM? Philosophical. He thinks, how did I get here? How did I get here? And as he thinks, he begins to sing.
Yourself.
just express our deepest gratitude to all of you as this kind of comes to a close, the summer tour. Also to everybody watching and listening at home, this is for you guys too, and everybody here. Basically what I want to say is that I can't really begin to tell you how much the four of us appreciate and feel blessed to be part of something that's become so, to us at least, you know, I'm talking about with this community, this scene that we look at every night, that's become so, so beautiful and so unique. So, I mean, I know we're up here playing the music, but this is kind of our chance to say that to you. We talk about it a lot backstage, like, you know, at the festival, and at the theater, at Dick's, and it's just such a good feeling, and you guys are kind of creating it all. So, we feel like we're a small part of that, whatever that is, you know? And we want to thank you guys, really, from the bottom of our hearts. So, it was a great summer, and we can't wait to catch up with you on the journey, wherever it goes next. Mexico, whatever. But, you know, there'll be a lot more. Hopefully we'll be back here again.